Chris, it's 3 points on the opening day. You must be delighted with that result and performance.
Delighted, obviously, with 3 points. Obviously, you want to try and set off. I said to the lads, everybody gets, everybody's got a point at the start of the game. Referees are quite generous. We've all got one. They give us one. We've got a clean sheet and we've got a point, and it was up to us to turn it into three. And today, you know, Solihull are a really good team, and we had to work very hard. They have a lovely process. I thought we kept that quite quiet, because I watched them last week against Walsall. Bostock completely controlled the game and bounced out regular to full backs. We were a little bit deep for me, and we never quite got Witts or the left back anxious on the ball. So they had sort of good passages of play, and to be fair to them, you know, they scored they scored a couple of goals, but they scored a really good goal.
Just how much character does it show from the lads to obviously go in at the break 2-1 down and still come out fighting and on the front foot?
Well, they were frustrated. It was a hot day. Because of the way Solihull played, we couldn't be off the leash. We're better off the leash. So I said at half time there's a different way of doing it, because what we worked on Friday in regards of off the ball setup, the way we wanted to jump press, we never actually did it. So I was frustrated as a coach, because I wanted to get an extra body up to help Charlie, and we talked about how we would do that. So we came up with a different version of it second half, and it helps, and Ethan can off the leash and go and help and put pressure on Witts, and then there's more turnovers of the ball, then we're getting more in control, then we're playing our football and we're attacking with more intent. You know, it was at times first half frustrating from the side, because we never really serviced Bryce. John never really took on the left back. We were doing good things without being great. And then second half, of course, it's really difficult for Solihull, because on a day like today, on a hot day, having a lad sent off, if that was us, we would have been in the same situation. And of course, Nick's goal's a goal good enough to win any game, his last goal. But I did say to him when he scored the goal, like, make sure it's got value, because it can get lost in the wash. But it did. It became a winning goal, so it's quite deserved.
And just on Nick Horton, obviously a hat trick on the opening day, doesn't get much better for him. But just describe his performance as a whole today.
Football's funny. You could see that in some of our players last season. You know, we've lost Connor Barrett because of that change. Nick had scored two goals in 15 games when I took over the job. He scored one with his head, well done Nick, and one in his own half. So I had to try and activate the way we play for him to be better off the ball, ironically. But because of that, he has now more dominance on the ball. And it's funny when you coach something opposite. So I do nothing technically in regards to getting on the ball, looking over your back shoulder, back foot takes, all the rest of it, coach jargon. It's about him working harder, and he does work harder now, and that's why. And he scored 16 goals last season for me in 31 games, and he started today with three. But I did say to him after, when the lads give him a bit of a clap and a well done, when he made sure he was last walking in the changing room, so he's definitely planned that. But I did say to him, I want a proper hat trick. I want a left foot, a right foot and a header, so we'll see if he can do that.
You spoke to me personally about how crucial substitutions could be this season in terms of how the numbers increased. Just how much did they play a part today?
Well, it helped us, but like I said, I don't think it's too much Solihull could have done because of the 10-man factor, and it was easier for me to make a stronger positive decision with more numbers. But the lads have to go on and make a difference, and they did. You know, they supported what we were doing and took it up a level. And there was a lot of change going on initially, because Joel Riley was on the left, inside left. Dan Ormond went up front. And then when we made more substitutions at 2-2, was it 3 came on to support Joel? So Joel then ended up centre mid. Then Corey gets a bang. Then he's now playing number 4. Luke Brennan's ended up right wing. So there's a lot going on in that, but the players applied themselves in that to make sure Solihull couldn't counter. And of course, it's a great winning goal, and the free kick's very intelligent, the second goal, but they were fouling us a lot at that point, because that's just a sign of pressure. It's the way we were playing, we were attacking. John Ostabashi was in, he had his jersey pulled, didn't he, when he span, and they were telling us it's an advantage, but he's being held while he's shooting. But they committed a lot of fouls, so it's because of the ascendancy we now had on our opponent.
And just finally, obviously you've said yourself that there's more to come from this team. Just how much does that excite you?
Well, it's exciting because it's very young. You know, we've got 21 players signed now, a couple of lads on loan. Patrick came on, did great, a few integral headers, important interception in and around the edge of the box before they could get a shot off. And of course we've got Ben, and Ben's not been able to train for the last 2 weeks. He only trained properly yesterday, so it worked right. He plays, it was right, Theo does. He did great against Barrett. Obviously I didn't watch the Ratcliffe game because I watched Solihull play. But them decisions I'll have to make. But we've got 21 lads, we've got four, only 18. So we're gonna grow and grow with this. But David's well supportive of me in regards to try to add one or two more attacking options to that group, because that will make us more physical, manly, and be able to make difference in the National League, because that's what you'll need, because the challenges are so broad, long, a lot of travelling as well, and we need to be right for all the different challenges we have.